episode. This is your boy Triple Cross Cash, man. Y'all go follow me at 3 Cross Cash, 3KRXSSKASHH. And shout out to Wake and Bake Morning Show, man. Y'all go get my single, Triple Cross My Heart. Be looking out for all my visuals, man. Be looking out for all my new stuff that's about to drop. Man, look, just support, man. Much love to everybody. Much love to the Wake and Bake Morning Show again. Appreciate the love. Appreciate y'all. Y'all be easy.
I'm working on dropping that mixtape. My mixtape gonna be called Cash Out.
Okay.
And it's gonna be spelled with a K.
Okay.
And it's gonna be red. It's gonna be a red Cash Out. One of my favorite colors. So
okay.
How we gonna do that? That's what I'm working on right now. I got a new single coming out called Why You Doing Like That. So I'm working on that right now as we speak. So, but yeah, that's about all I got. Y'all ain't heard that dirt and that cash and need, y'all gonna hit.
Okay. So you got any collabs with anybody else?
I do. I got a me and my cousin Shine, Triple Cross Shine.
Okay.
We got a song called Slow Zone. So yeah, we trying to get ready to drop that song too.
Okay.
And we got a couple more collabs coming. I got a couple collabs from supposed to be coming from Chip. I got a song supposed to be coming from who else? I got one person named Chat. Yeah, matter of fact, he just popped up. Yeah. I'm supposed to be in the feature from him too, but he be playing, man.
Is it any major artists that you would like to collab with? You feel me? In the game? Or you just got them be vibing out to your own campaign?
Yeah, that's true. I do vibe my own shit. I'd rather do that before I try to get my hopes up to working with somebody big, because they already got money. I'm trying to get the money. You know, I'm trying to get that. I want it. And
yeah.
I mean, and I'm hungry enough to push it on my own if I got to.
That's
and without asking one of them for a handout or something like that. Because that's how I kind of see it as a handout. Like, I don't want to ask them, like, oh, yeah, let me, I want a major feature. And then that time coming, they, you know what I'm saying, they treat me like something, like I'm a groupie type nigga. Like, I ain't trying to have that going on.
Yeah, right. So, as far as visuals, you got any visuals up?
I'm working on them now, too. I'm supposed to be ready to drop a Triple Cross My Heart video and Two Bad Bitches in the Maybach. I'm supposed to be ready to drop them two visuals.
Okay,
so, y'all be looking for them, too. You looking for them, they coming real soon.
So is there any major artists that inspired you to do music, like coming up?
Yes. I'm going to have to say one of my top is Wayne.
Okay.
Wayne, he one of my top, because I just like his flow, how he use his words. You know what I'm saying?
Wayne going hard.
Like, his words is just crazy. Like, you'll hear some shit you ain't never heard before from him. Like.
Yeah.
So him, Gucci, a lot of producers inspired me to want to go all that music too.
Okay, so what producers you like?
Like Zay,
yeah.
Metro.
Yeah.
I forgot what dude name. He an older dude though.
He
I forgot his name. Mm-hmm. He from up here. He an older guy though. Like he been. I guess he been doing it for like years. I forgot his name. I was just looking at him. I was just watching him last night on my phone. But I know him. I got it'll come to me. But him,
put out a lot of good.
Right. So I'm like, I like Takey. his sound different.
Yeah. So you be more into the production of the goddamn. Mm-hmm.
I like that's, the sound. Like that sound. That sound come to
That's what I like. I mean, cause that's the basis of a song. You feel me? When you hear that motherfucker come on, even before the fucking words come on, You be like, oh yeah, this that goddamn motherfucker right here. And shit, the goddamn words just accent the motherfucking beat.
That's how most of my songs, that's how I went off of Maybach, Two Bad Bitches in Maybach. Like, that beat was just like, okay. And if you really listen to what I'm saying and listen to the beat is actually saying my words.
Yeah.
You mean? So that's how I see it. Like, that's what I'm listening to. I like listening to the sign. That sign touched me. I'm going with it. So that's how I go off of doing my music.
How do you go about, you deal with a certain producer that you vibe out with, or you just go out and select different beats from different producers?
Nah, I actually start out with the YouTube beat. Like, you know, some be on there, that'd be free, or whatever, they say it free, or whatever. And I go off of them, but I have an engineer, Good Green Shouter. He was my engineer for a point of time. And then I learned from him. I learned most of my stuff from him. So I know how to
work the
board. Yeah, I know how to do it too, a little bit to a certain extent.
Okay. So that's what's up, man, to be hands on with the situation then.
Yeah, cause when I first learned how to record myself, after that I just was like, okay, if I can do that, if I can just click a space bar and record myself, I know I can play with the soundboard and play with my vocals and do this right here and learn how to do this here. Like I can do that. And I sat down and watched him just play with certain sounds and play with certain vocal chords and plugins and stuff like that. And I'm like, okay, I can do that. Like, I can from here, from recording to here, I can do that.
Yeah.
So I'm still trying to progress and learn on how to do more stuff to where I can just record, do my own thing. Cause I got my own studio at home. So.
So I heard you say you was checking out a producer. Do you educate yourself as far as being an artist, as far as the game, like past doing music? Like, do you do any kind of research as far as the business?
Yes and no. I ain't gonna lie. Yes and no. But some of the stuff like I've looked into, like 360 deals.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've looked into that. And that's something that I'm not even trying to, you feel me? Because that's lame as hell. Like, I don't even gonna lie. That's lame. For no cap. Like, for nobody, it's like you getting nothing. You know, and you just working for them, basically. You just putting out music for nothing. And you really ain't getting much out of it. Yeah. I'd rather push my own. That's why we got our own label, Triple Cross NT. That's why we pushing it for ourselves, cause we want our own money.
Yeah.
We want them to say, oh well, oh, they go to them. Yeah, without nobody saying, oh well, you owe me half or you owe me 25% of this, 55% of this, 75%. When I know 100% of the money comes to us. Period.
Yeah. That's the best way to. If you're an indie artist and you got a major campaign going, then it's best to stay indie. To me. Because it seems like you're gonna make the same thing with less strings attached to your ad.
Exactly.
So if I'm sign a deal and make $1 million and then I gotta do all this shit, or either I can stay an indie artist and I don't have to do none of that shit and still make that same $1 million.
Exactly.
And don't have to sell my soul, what's the fucking difference? You feel me?
But I done heard a lot about rapper doing that. That's selling that soul, that's lame. That ain't for me. I don't want to do nothing like that.
I mean,
I can't judge nobody because that's their life.
Yeah.
But me personally, I'm not trying to go
it's
down that
road. It's the path that you take once you get the money, what you going to do with it after that.
Exactly.
You feel me? Because you got other avenues to generate money once you get into the game and you expose yourself to everybody, and you done basically created a lane for you to have your own 360 deal. Yeah. Cause people gonna want to sign you, or you can promote whatever products and your own products that you want to promote.
And I don't have a big head with it. I don't be trying to be greedy or none of that. That's why I always say us, man, we, because we win.
Yeah.
triple crossover. And that's how I always need to be.
So are you trying to incorporate that into a brand? Like, are you trying to make any kind of triple cross t-shirts?
Oh, yeah, we got, triple cross fashion.
Okay.
You got a t-shirt right there. She got one of our t-shirts on right there. Okay. I should have brought some on, but yeah, we got a t-shirt. We got a clothing line. Like, she run it. I just design whatever logo we want to put on there, or however we want to do it. But we got some shirts and hoodies.
Come out and push your own brand, because it's all about really branding yourself. You feel me? And promoting your own shit.
Right.
So anytime you out, you know what I mean? You got to be out. Your shit.
Fact.
Behind the camera, you want everybody see you. So it's good that you promote your own shit and doing your own thing, but you got to promote. You got to go hard for that shit. People right. See you going hard and goddamn for your own shit, and they goddamn going to be like, oh, yeah, I'm
fucking
alive.
And a lot of people. I'm glad you said it, because a lot of people been doing it. I'm like, man, y'all really pushing that shit. Like, dang.
Yeah.
Like, how y'all doing this? Or how you, like, tell me how you got about doing it right here. And I don't mind telling them, because it feel good for them to be like, yeah, bro, I like what you doing. I like what you got going on. Yeah.
Support equals success, man. And you can't do nothing but go up. You know what I mean? Because I do something. You know what I mean? Somebody ain't going to be able to do it like how you do it. You feel me? I could tell somebody, I could show somebody my whole recipe. But I still might leave out one ingredient.
Right.
You feel
me? Right. Because they can't get the whole pie.
You feel me? Yeah, no. Can't get their left and right hand on. Left hand doing something.
Exactly.
You feel me? That's just it, dude. So the next vibes we finna goddamn jump into, goddamn. We finna drop.
I'm gonna drop that two bitches on Maybach.
Yes, sir.
Man, we finna goddamn ride out, goddamn, on the Livest
one.
On
the
mic,
man.
From the dirt, we ain't need it for free. And the back got two bitches with me.